One cannot hear the word chef without one name coming immediately to mind. No, not him. No, not him. No, not him. Yes, Chef Roy McQueen. Chef McQueen has been the epitome of the word chef for as long as many of us can remember. To learn Chef McQueen's history is to learn the history of professional cooking. 16th century England. A young playwright by the name of William Shakespeare was taking the theatrical world by storm in a small village called Stratford-upon-Avon. It was in Stratford that our young Chef McQueen got his start, and at about that time, the Globe Theatre was the venue of Shakespeare's productions, and young Roy ran the concession stand there. His sparrow tarts are still spoken of in hushed whispers.
Sparrow tarts, sparrow tarts, sparrow tarts.
Legend has it that Roy has been immortalized in at least one of the bard's works. At the time he was writing A Midsummer Night's Dream, Shakespeare was living in a small room in the Globe. Young Roy was notorious for sneaking into the playwright's room and quaffing his ale. On many an evening, upon finding his hogshead empty, Shakespeare would storm through the theatre in search of the culprit. His cries of, "Where is that little puck?" were recalled in his famous comedy. He may have been misquoted. Chef McQueen stayed on in Stratford and eventually found himself at the Royal Shakespeare Theatre, working as a cook and as the sommelier. In his time at the Royal, Roy struck up many friendships with the visiting celebrity actors. Of most note is Roy's intimate acquaintance with Dame Diana Rigg. Roy's fashion sense might well have been the inspiration for one of British television's most enduring characters, the Silly Walk Man. From Stratford, Chef McQueen went on to London, to the Savoy Hotel, where a young upstart by the name of Auguste Escoffier was holding sway in the kitchens. The advice that Roy gave the young cook, of adding a bit more salt and making the portions a bit bigger, was taken to heart by Escoffier, and in his book, Ma Cuisine, he credits Roy with his success. In fact, Escoffier's signature dish, Oeufs McQueen, was named in honor of Roy. After single-handedly popularizing French cuisine in England, Chef McQueen set his sights on a new adventure. Canada. With its vast wilderness and non-existent cuisine, Canada was the perfect canvas upon which Chef McQueen could work his art. And work it he did. Roy took his Mac brand and gave North America a culinary kick in the chops, with Mac foods sprouting up everywhere. It was only a matter of time before Chef McQueen met his soulmate, Bonnie, a young cook of the same stock as Roy, a chef whose culinary exploits rivaled his own. Together, the McQueens brought gastronomic enlightenment to North America and beyond. Many world leaders sought the McQueens out for their culinary expertise. Communist dictator Fidel Castro was particularly fond of their work. So much so that he invited the McQueens for an extended visit. Their Epicurean joie de vivre was matched only by a bunch of other big words. As he did with everything, Roy took the opportunity to pass the baton on with good grace.
Roy, you got the package. Roy. Come on, Roy. Roy, come on, take the package. It's a great package.
It's got a few holes in it.
Although retired, I'm sure that Roy and Bonnie will continue to share their love of food for many years to come.
Bet you're going fishing all of the time, baby going fishing too. Bet your life, your sweet wife, will catch more fish than you.
Bonnie and Roy, in the words of Douglas Adams, so long, and thanks for all the fish.
It's been good times.
Going fishing, yes, I'm going fishing, and my baby going fishing too.